Next person coming up, beautiful young woman. She's a part of an organization that's here in Richmond. She's the program director, and Dion McCutcheon is the founder and executive director of IAMGIRL Inc. It's a nonprofit organization for all girls ages 8 through 18, and they operate in the metro Richmond area, empowering and uplifting girls today to define women and a purpose of tomorrow. And I'm excited to have her because she's talking about one of my favorite subjects. The guys probably won't appreciate it, but the women will. And we're going to be talking about beauty on a budget. So give it up for Tasha Moore, ladies and gentlemen. Woo-hoo. Woo-hoo. If you want more information, please feel free to stop by our table. I don't want to spend too much time talking about the organization, but if you have questions, please make sure you stop by, or any girls or people who are interested in volunteering or anything like that. So yeah, we're talking about beauty on a budget. We thought we'll start with the most important thing, which is what? Your inner beauty. Some people have already touched on that, which is great. We're just gonna piggyback off that, get some more information. Some of the first things you wanna remember when working on being a beautiful person is to smile. It lifts your spirits as well as others to radiate positivity. So giving off that positive energy with smiles and being friendly. Also give yourself and others a compliment. Be confident and uplifting yourself. Like, be comfortable with being able to give yourself a compliment. I look nice today. I really like my hair like this. You know, something like that that can keep you motivated within yourself. And also, give others compliments. You don't know the last time they received a compliment. Nothing can make a person's world. Also, being optimistic. So, thinking positively in all situations instead of contemplating a problem. Think about a solution. So instead of focusing on the negative things that's going on, it's something like, we had a program yesterday with our girls where we asked them, we got in a big circle, hey, what was the high of your week? What was the low of your week? But we started with the lows, and then we had to figure out what the high was, because there's something good that happens to each and every one of us. If you're here, that means something good happened to you. You woke up. So it took some girls a little more, you know, it was a little harder for some, the younger ones, but we got something up every last one, whether it was I got straight A's, my teacher made me mad, whatever the situation may have been. But we got those lows out of the way.
Okay, yeah, all right. Yeah, so we wanted to touch a little bit more on, you know, more specifically, you know, of course, inner beauty is the one thing that's gonna make you most beautiful. I mean, it don't matter what you look like, size, shape, color, anything, if you feel that you're beautiful on the inside, it literally radiates. I'm telling you, I know people who just know they are the stuff. And even if no one else feels that way about them, it does not matter because they are so comfortable within themselves. And you have no idea how much you attract people, attract positive energy, attract a lot of positivity from you being that confident and comfortable within yourself. So that's very important. But we also wanted to touch on some things like, Tasha's gonna talk a little bit about how you can get some makeup on a budget.
Makeup on a budget, skincare. We all know that on the outside, the outer appearance is good with the clothes, but skincare is most important. I know a lot of us, as we get older, we adapt the different skincare products that we know works for ourselves. But I like to always be adventurous and try new things. It's not always good to do that with your skin, especially if you have sensitive skin. But if you know that you don't have that and you can kind of go out and try different products, then it's always good to be able to do that because makeup can be very expensive, especially when you buy some of the larger brands. But there are also smaller brands that are really, really great to be able to use, and it's affordable. And it's one of the things that I like to be able to present to the girls itself, because as young women, you don't want to be heavy in the makeup. You don't want to do a whole lot with your skin, but it's easy to be able to go and utilize some of the smaller products. Here, I have a makeup case, and you can see it. I love makeup, so this is large. You definitely don't have to go this big when you're talking about organizing all of your products. One of the things that I also buy and that I use is some of the smaller ones that this may have cost like $3 or $4 from Target. But being able to be fashionable, but also be organized. Sometimes when you're on the go, when you're on the run, you want to make sure that you have things in order so that you can be able to use them easily accessible. But this is the organizer that you can also use to put your makeup in. Some of the products that I like to use that are very affordable is NYX products from the stores. They have a lot of makeup. They have foundation. They have products that you can use on your skin, nails, hair, all of that. Target also has and more affordable line too. It's called Elf. They're really, really cheap. They go from $1 to like $5, but you can buy all of your makeup products in there. Target is a great store to be able to buy a lot of products. Some of the things that NYC I like the most are the foundations. Also, some of the other makeup products that you can use there too. These kind of came from Victoria's Secret. It's always good to go into, even though some of the stores like Sephora and MAC and some of the over-the-counter stores can be expensive. Sometimes they have things on sale, especially around the holiday time, so being able to just kind of go in there and shop. But those are just some of the products that I like to be able to purchase. So the makeup, the skincare is always the best. Like I said, starting with a good foundation, making sure you clean your skin, making sure that you moisturize your skin, making sure that you take off the makeup at night. I know sometimes we have long days and we have the makeup on our face all day, but sometimes that can clog your pores, sometimes it can get you oily. So make sure at night, before you go to bed, you wash your face, you moisturize, those type of things. Start with a good base, and then be able to work your way outer. And like I said, less is more. So sometimes just putting on mascara and eyeliner is good, and a good lipstick. Finding a good lipstick is hard, but when you find it, you got it, and you know it works for you. So that's the face. So we have some different clothes here that we're going to talk about how to turn from day to night simple so that you don't have to do too much, being able to be comfortable kind of during the day and then transitioning to night and also transitioning from season to season.
Right, so Tasha's great at makeup. I suck at it, but I'm really good with eyeliner and mascara, and that's pretty much what I can do. But what I am really into is the whole fashion piece. I'm really into clothes and things like that, Tasha, but she noticed I was very quiet on that piece. But I just wanted to, we're going to talk about, like she said, about changing your outfit from a day to a night outfit, but also how to use things throughout the season. Sometimes stuff, you know, I don't always have money to go buy new things all the time. I know I don't. So I do things like take things that I can also use maybe from the spring or summertime, make it a fall outfit. And this is just an example. It's not something for everybody. But you can do something like, say something as simple as a little romper. This is a shorts set. So it's shorts and it has like a little top connected to it. Take something as simple as a romper. That could be a summer or spring outfit if you want, but then add a pair of tights to it. You add some tights to it. These are leg warmers. You can get these anywhere. They can be very inexpensive as well. You add a pair of leg warmers to it. A knee boot. You can get these rainbow, any other place that you want to get them. Depends on where you shop. I think these came from Macy's. And then take something like a sweater I have on now, you have a full fall outfit. So you added a sweater, some tights, boots, but it's a jumper, it's a short set that you wore maybe during the spring and summertime. So being able to take skirts or shorts that you may have and add a nice boot, a cardigan, a nice blazer, something over top to keep you warm, a nice scarf. So people, you can get scarves from Rugged Warehouse and places like that that are very expensive. And put a nice scarf over it with your cardigan. You have a whole new outfit that you've been wearing all year. Tasha, talk a little bit more about the day to night look.
This is a simple look that I pieced together. Sometimes things you are not comfortable with, don't be afraid to mix denims because it's in. You can do that. Again, you have to do what works for you. But this is just a shirt. I think that I got this probably from Target and it was on the sale rack. That's one of the things that I do the best when I go to the stores, go to the sales rack first. It's not, don't think that you're trying to be cheap and you're going to those things. You can find some of the best things on the sale rack. Sometimes it's the last pieces or it's the last size or whatever. So you always go to the sales rack. I think I got this from Target. These jeans are simple too. Straight leg jeans always work well for a lot of different things, especially when you're talking about wearing them with sneakers, flats, boots, heels. They work good. Again, you have to know your body type though and what works for you and what makes you feel comfortable. This particular outfit, I wanted to dress it down. I work during the day. I work for the city and I have to dress up all the time. So when I can put on sneakers, I do that. But you can also feel like a woman and feel, you know, that you have that feminine approach by putting on something like this that can have a little shoulder out, a little shoulder action, if you're okay with that. And then a sneaker that you can dress this down with. I put here wear it with the sneaker, something that you won't have to accessorize too much with. But then when you change it tonight, you can put on a little bit more fancier hoop and then put it on with a pair of boots just to dress it up. And it's easy to be able to do that. Like Leon said, sometimes you can bring a sweater to go with it. You might have to have another shirt on to go up underneath it. Having separates is always good so that you can always put them with different things and you don't have to continue to buy more on top of that. And then accessorizing is always simple to be able to just change an outfit. Accessories matter the most of the time when you're putting on, you know, an outfit because it can make or break it and it can change the look completely. As women, we have so many options really of being able to go to stores and find things because we can dress things up and put on accessories and make it look like it costs a lot of money. And that's why in that moment, again, less is more, because if you can just accessorize it, then it makes you look good and it puts the outfit together. So that's what we have. Anybody have any questions, anything? No? Okay.
Thank you.
Well, thank you.